Alrighty, here we go. So this is gonna be a quick, short, but effective tutorial. Let's go. Of course, it starts with a save. So I've been trying to figure out how the automatic pilots work more closely and in detail, and to understand how these things stack. So I've been trying around looking for tutorials, found none. So I thought I'm gonna make a quick one. If anybody is looking for this, here it is. The logic of the automatic pilot is very simple, and it will explain everything later, how it works. So basically what this thing tries to do is it will take a stack that is coming in and it will put it onto the stack that is immediately following it. And if that stack is full, it will basically put out four. So if you look here, basically there's one coming out and it's coming out a little bit later than it's going in. So basically what it does, it takes this stack and it puts it one behind. Since there's nothing behind, it will not stack. So it is not waiting for something to come out and then stack it on two. No, it will just stack onto the one that is immediately behind it. So in order for this to work, the input must be full. If there's a space in between, it will not stack. So what happens if I upgrade now this and I basically make it a full coming in? So here basically this is like almost a full. Let's make it really full. So I'm gonna downgrade this. I want this to flow very slowly so that we really see what is happening. I'm just gonna add a second of these, a second sorter, so that it is really full. So basically what it theoretically should do, it should basically take one and put it on the next one. So on the other side of the sorter, there should come out a two space, two space, two space. So let's see. It's not working. Yes, of course, I knew it. I put it the wrong way. Great. Great tutorial. Great tutorial. Well done. Very well done. It's just perfect. So, like you see here, what it's doing, it is taking one and then putting. So there's two of them here. I chose the wrong material. But nevertheless, you should see it that there's two. So this is basically water. So I can undo all of this and turn them all around, because what I did is kind of nonsense. I prepared this all nicely for this tutorial, and then of course I screwed up at the last moment by putting this the wrong way. So let me quickly fix this. Apologies for that. I'm already hesitating to redo it all from scratch, but no, it's gonna be pretty quick here. Well, you already got the principle. So basically the idea is the stacker, or the whatever they call it, the automatic piler. I don't know where they get the words from, but okay, it will basically just take whatever comes in and put it on the prior one. So if there's none before, it will just put it on the empty belt and then we'll keep on going. So what you see here is just this. So the reason why I put so many in a row is there's a good reason. It's really to understand. But I mean, if you basically understood the first concept where it just explained, then you have it all. But I want to illustrate it how this really works at the end of the day. So back here, so there's a full belt coming in of one, and here you can see it quite well. So he puts a two. So what happens here? Nothing. Because he basically just tries to pick the two and put it on the next one. The next one being empty, while it just displaces these two. So what I did here is the idea to add always in between one. So I'm gonna take three of them, so really have a full belt here. So what happens here, basically, it just intersects one. So the idea here, so you have here two, one. What will happen? He will basically take the two, put it on the one that's behind, and we're gonna make it a three out of it. So on the next one you will see there's threes coming out. So he took the two and puts it on the next one, which is a one, or he takes the one and puts it on the next one, which is a two, but anyways it's always a three. So there's threes coming out here. Now here I intersect again a one. So what is going to happen here? Of course, he would add it. So theoretically, from what I say, he's going to take the 3 and put it on the 1, make a 4. Or take the 1 and put it on the 3 and make a 4. So let's see. Yes, basically does a 4. Now, I'm going to inject again 1. So what is going to happen now? He's basically taking the 4. He's putting it onto the 1. The 4 onto the 1, that's 5. So he basically then going to keep that 1. He's going to put out 4. He's going to keep that 1 and put it on the next one. And the next one is a 4. So there's another 4 coming out. And the next one is a 1. So there is going to be 4, 4, 2. Let's see. 4, 4, 2. So again, he's taking the 4, putting it onto the next one, which is a 1. So that's a 5. So he's going to put out a 4. And then he's keeping that 1 and he's going to put it on the next one. So we had a 4, we had a 1, the next one is a 4. So he's going to again have a 5. So he's going to put out another 4. And then he's going to have left 1. That 1, he's going to put it onto the next one, which is a 1. So that's going to be a 2. So we come out with a 4, 4, 2. So if I inject again 1, what's going to happen now? So a threat. So he's going to take the 4, it's full, good out. He's going to take the next one, which is a 4, it's going to go full out. The next one is a 2. The next one gives a 3. A 1. So he's going to put the 2 on the 3. So it's going to be 4, 4, 3. 4, 4, 3. Now, the next one is pretty straightforward. The next one is going to be a 4, 4, 4. Because basically takes the 4, cannot put anything on, puts it out. Takes another 4, cannot put anything on, takes it out. Takes then the 3, puts it on the 1, is a 4. Let's see. 4, 4. Ah, he's not doing what I thought. Wait a minute. This one is too fast. So, let me see. Yes, this is better. Because there was one. So here, basically, he's then taking the 4, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 3. So, what's the next one? So basically now, like I said, he takes the 4, puts it on, takes another 4, puts it on, and then takes the 3, puts it with the 4, and then takes the next one, which is kind of, now the sun is coming up, and since this is water, yeah, okay, anyways, you got the concept. So now let's see, if I take that in, again, gonna downgrade this, because it now must be in the same speed, all of them. So basically now, you see he's gonna, this is an issue. I know where the problem lies. Okay, we need more resources here. I was wondering, why is this a mess? So, no, up. Upgrade. This must be fast, very fast. Very fast, very fast, very fast, very fast. Because I basically want this line here to be full, otherwise it won't work. Yes, this is better. So let's see what happens here. Now this is becoming more regular. This should actually be 3/4. Yes, now it's correct. So this is really how it should be going. 3/4. I was wondering earlier, was kind of weird. So basically I have here 4/4/4. So now the next one is going to be, that's an interesting one. You got to see, so 4/4/4/4. So there's 3 times 4 and then a 2. Why? Basically takes the first 4. It's full, takes it out. Then he makes the next 4, it's full, take it out. Then he makes the next 4, it's full, taking out. Then he takes the 1 and he tries to put it on the 4. So it's going to be a 4 full. So the next one is a 4 again, it's full. The next one is a 4 again, it's full. And the next one is a 1, and he has 1 over, so that's a 2. And then there's an empty space. So again, like I said, he takes what he has as first and puts it onto the next one. And if that one is full, he basically puts out the 4 and then takes the rest onto the next one. So here again, now we are more or less at the end here. Here we are at almost, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then a 3. And then we would be at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4. And so the issue which you're going to have here by doing this in a row is that it will take you a lot of stackers before actually you are full. Look, I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it's still not a full belt. So what you definitely need to do if you want to use these stackers, first of all, the first row must be full, and then you would basically take a line like here, a second line, and then here, put this on. This is going to be a quick one, and then basically I'm going to take this one out like this. And of course here you're going to have a 2 coming out and a 2 coming out, so all of these are 2 2. So what's going to happen, of course, is going to create force out of it. So 4 4 4 and then empty. So if you do 2 stackers like this, so if you basically stack the items like a 2, a 2, a 2, a 2, and then, so here, this. So if I do this, basically coming from here, going in here, coming from here, going in here, and this one goes in here, coming from here, so, so this will give you 4 items stacked only this one, because, and only if these 4s are full. This is all correct, yes, because basically what happens is here is going to make 2 empty, 2 empty, 2 empty, 2 empty. Here's going to make the same. They're going to get together here, so there's going to be 2s all over the place, and here's going to be 4 empty, 4 empty, 4 empty, the same on the other side, and then only here the 4s will be full. So if we were to illustrate this, let's try. What's the best way to do this? Oh, that's a good question. I would need, let me copy paste this. To right here. Have space here. Yes. And then I'm just gonna go down here. Since this is water, I'm gonna put it into a water tank. And then take out the water from here on a quick one. So this is really the fastest belt. So. And of course it needs electricity. Well, that's and this one must not output in 4, but let's put this back to 1. So you see basically here he's putting out 2s. Well, let's downgrade this so that you see it better. I'm gonna downgrade all of these, so this is all going, so just to illustrate for the speed. So you see it takes the 1 1 1 2 2 2, and then here same, I take the water out, and that's a 1 1 1, and that's gonna be a 2 2 2 0 2 0 2 0. So, and then of course they stack perfectly together, so there's no loss in speed, and he makes out 4s of these. And obviously if I do the same here, on the opposite, so I just need of course to put the filter of water here, water and water. So you will see now he's basically again doing exactly the same on the other side. So there's a 2 2 2, there's a 4 4 4, and obviously he will end up creating 4 here. So if I go closer, try to, so this is a 4 4 4 4 4 4, is puts them together, and then you got a perfect line of force. So this is the only and most effective way to basically get of ones ones, so ones, O-N-E-S, twos together and then fours. So this is the best way to stack this. This is quite important when you basically try to build factories where you basically take out four, but you want to also put in four. So there's in my game, you will see that I play a lot around with these ones currently because I'm at the late level of production. So I have high speed productions and this is definitely what I need. Okay, well, that's it for this small tutorial. I'm gonna end it here and then going back to my normal stream. And yep, if you need anything or if you want to see anything else like this, just let me know. So here you can build this for yourself and just see how it works. So let me put this one here again. Now this is like really, I was really, in the beginning I tried to produce outputs and I was really like taken aback by the way it works, but now I've actually understood what he effectively does. It makes perfect sense. Now here is ones coming out, yes. Oh, I put it in stacker here. I was wondering, why is it weird over there? There should not be a stacker, but okay. Okay, well, see you in my stream. Hope you learned something. Took me some time to find this out. Bye-bye.